victory. Jimmy at the right swoops out of the shadows. Got me on the night. Somewhere some villain schemes, but his number's up.
3, 2, 1.
You know, viewer, we've seen a lot of AAA games come and go on this channel, both good and bad. They've usually had their places. Probably not the shit COD wannabes done by Nspace, which was a myriad of garbage masquerading as an attempt to keep the studio afloat, but I don't think I've ever had to ask the question of why a video game exists. Since I don't cover Steam's never-ending trash-a-palooza, I suppose. But Umbrella Chronicles really breaks the mold in terms of failing to find an identity for itself. I'm not saying that this game is crap terrible, but I would find it hard to get a recommendation in spite of it being a pretty solid on-rail shooter for the Wii. The selling point here is that this is an on-rail shooter from Capcom that runs the player through the greatest moments of Resident Evil 0, Resident Evil, Resident Evil 2, and presumably Resi 3, but I'm not too sure on that one. The last campaign might be entirely new for Umbrella Chronicles, but I'd highly doubt that. If you remember any Resi games taking place on a Russian oil derrick in the middle of a blizzard, then that's it. So we already have a major problem in Umbrella Chronicles, is that it's the Resident Evil Greatest Hits record, which never does all that well, because some fans will say, why would I want this compilation when I've still got all the games that inspired it? Especially when it's being run through an entirely new gameplay model, the on-rail shooting thing. Don't take me the wrong way here, it's solid gameplay through and through. Responsive, satisfying, has a good camera that unfortunately Capcom takes control away from you randomly and unpredictably, which goes with the whole survival horror thing, and yet a few times it'll end up tossing you into a threat that you really can't deal with and therefore takes health away. Umbrella Chronicles is pretty good about its health, mostly. First aid sprays are 50-50 hidden in random background objects, which is pretty bullshit, but if you're diligent in the first parts of the level, they're pretty easy to find. So you're never caught too short, which is good since the game dabbles in some of the bosses from its revisited games. Stinger from Zero, Yawn from Resi, and the Ultimate Tyrant from the Motherland, amongst a bunch of others that require your utmost attention. Yet, that was the issue I was having while playing the game, is wondering what I was getting out of Umbrella Chronicles that I couldn't get from just replaying Resident Evil and Resi 2. To be fair to Capcom, they were diligent in recreating the notable areas of the game with the whole redux of the Spencer Mansion, the cutscenes, the run through Raccoon City, and all that jazz, but it's your basic greatest hits product that celebrates the success of a franchise. Considering that Umbrella Chronicles is still trying to be survival horror for whatever that counts for, I don't see what adding in the on-rail shooter element adds to these four games, other than it possibly being just contract work for Nintendo. I will say that the game's selling point isn't so much the greatest hits thing, but Capcom also added in some prologue sections that you can unlock throughout the game if you hit certain ranks on missions, which is pretty crap if you ask me. To get the extra content that would justify the game's existence, I have to hit A ranks on some frankly hardcore difficult missions. You would think that a game that is recreating four separate titles would constantly be recycling the difficulty curve to give the impression that we're seeing the best moments of four games. But when you get to the earliest parts of Resi 2 and Resi Russia, they hit you hard right from the get-go because the game is keeping the difficulty curve going throughout every chapter of all four games. It's not necessarily a bad thing, but when you get 10 minutes into the first chapter of Resi Russia and suddenly you're onset by 15 hunters in a row, That tends to damper the fun I was trying to have just a little bit. While the on-rails revisits of old Resi games is fun and all, the prologue chapters that the game tacks on to help support the game with new content doesn't do much for anybody after all. The prologue bits are chapters added in by Capcom to help explain the behind-the-scenes events and off-screen connections between the games that the original players of those Resi games didn't see, like seeing what happened to Wesker after he was killed in the original Resi, where Rebecca went after Resi Zero, and those sorts of things. The giant issue with these prologues is that you could basically get the same explanation as to what happened by making a guess. How did Wesker get out of the mansion? Answer: he left. What happened to Lisa Trevor? Wesker shot her to pieces. Where did Rebecca Chambers go? She went into the mansion and was the only survivor of Bravo Team. The answers to the questions explained by Umbrella Chronicles is stuff we already know about. We saw them happen in other games. So what's the point of these prologues? They're basically just sections where we see characters move from point A to point B. The point of a prologue game, explained masterfully by Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater, is that it exists to explain a backstory, to give us a detailed origin that we don't know about beforehand. And if you want to do a prologue, then you have to be willing to explain things in depth, and Umbrella Chronicles does not have that. The sections are too short and sparse on dialogue and actual content that they aren't simply fit for purpose and end up as complete wastes of time. They are essentially gameplay filler to give you more time with Umbrella Chronicles. And since my original question was wondering why this game exists in the first place, making it pointlessly longer doesn't make it a more quality product. Although, if the Russia oil derrick turns out to be an entirely new level design for Umbrella Chronicles, then I am willing to mostly take that criticism back, as it tells the story of the downfall of Sergei, an amazingly stereotypical Umbrella leader, and the ultimate failure of the entire Tyrant project. There is one more thing I need to point out that makes the game fall flat on its face, is that its progression system is dreadful. What the game gives you for completing levels are upgrade points for the various guns you can find in the game. All the Resi classics. Pistol, shotgun, SMG, rocket launcher, and grenade launcher. The facepalm-worthy problem is that the game simply gives you too many guns for this to be of any use. Perfect example is that the game has two different SMGs, a standard and a military grade model. The standard one you get first, and if you start putting upgrade points into it, then you quickly find out that you totally wasted that cash. Because once the military grade one gets introduced, the only ammunition in the game is for that SMG, which you get about halfway through, so why would you be saving upgrades for that weapon you didn't know existed? Also, the game doesn't even come close to having enough upgrade points available for the ridiculous arsenal you acquire throughout the game. With the game constantly introducing more guns and totally forgetting to give you ammunition for the previous ones, the upgrade system in Umbrella Chronicles is completely useless and therefore keeps putting you in situations where you're not leveled up enough to take on the increasingly difficult hordes throughout the entire game. You can never get a leg up on the monsters in the game because you aren't able to upgrade faster, then the monsters get worse and more numerous. While this game might have simply been a contract job from Nintendo just to get something recognizable on the Wii, it is a bit better than it has a right to be with the detailed work from Capcom to get the environments from the original games fully rendered for an on-rail shooter. But the total lack of new content, sparse collectibles, and no unique gameplay changes makes this game feel like a one-note spin-off that no one really cared about. The one justification that game had was its new content prologue sections that does so little to tell a story that the total plot summary could be explained in a loading screen or a Resident Evil file. Character went to a place and survived all the bullshit is what it boils down to mostly. So you are going to get more of your mileage out of this game from the greatest hits levels. But if that's the case, I ask again, why would you buy this game instead of just replaying the inspiration that you already own? This game must have really felt pointless even when it launched, even to Resident Evil fans. And unfortunately, not even the game's moronic writing and dialogue can make it a so bad it's good project. I can't recommend it, people. Before even considering this game, just buy the main series Resident Evil once. There is nothing in this game that makes it a must-have creative spin-off, even if it's still a solid on-rail shooter. I'll leave you as always with a final scoreboard. And a standard victory for gamers. Thanks for joining me once again.